Hey everyone, it's Jenny. It's been a little while since I chatted with you guys. I've actually been crazy busy myself. And I just wanted to see how everybody's doing. I mean, this is October 18th, 2021. Like, oh my God, right? Where has the time gone? Like, holy smokes, right? So today we are still in Mercury retrograde, but the energy has ended today being October 18th, right? But we are now moving into the Aries full moon, which is the blood moon on October 20th. So I just wanted to go over a little bit with you about what's been going on in October with like the Mercury retrograde and different modalities. And now we're entering into the full moon. Okay. And then at the very end, I'm going to put down just a couple of cards from spirit, as I say, right? So you guys got to remember, like, the first thing is, as you can see, there's so much craziness still going on, right? The world has gone crazy. But is that anything new? No. Is that ever going to change? No. What you see is what you get. Okay. So as you guys have to take a look at it, take a look at what level of consciousness you're at. How are you guys seeing things? How are you guys viewing things? Is what it comes down to. Okay. We all see things in our own way from our own level of perspective. However, what is most important is you guys have to respect each other. Okay. Regardless of what, for those who are vaxxed, for those who are not vaxxed, it doesn't matter. Okay, just stay in whatever you guys resonate within yourself. Bottom line, I'm not going to go on about it. As you guys can see, there's a whole new world war starting with all of this vax or no vax energies. Okay, go with what resonates with you. End of story. Okay, so right now, during the Mercury retrograde, okay, everything has gone up in the air with technology. Do you guys remember that when Facebook, Instagram, and WhatsApp went down? Mercury retrograde, of course, brings down technology. That's the worst thing I personally hate about technology, is that I'm online every single day for my business and my work. And when the internet is down, oh my God, right? However, you guys can't fight with that. You can't. Good luck with it, right? Just go with the flow with it all. And Mercury gave us that opportunity to reset things, to reevaluate things, to end things, to begin things. What's just not working anymore, right? What is working? Where do you guys want to go? What do you guys want to end? Okay, so that's the beauty of Mercury retrograde that I especially love, right? It gives you that opportunity to really revamp things, okay? And keep in mind that this energy is going to go on for a couple of weeks yet. The energy will start to calm down a little bit more, okay, as each day ends Mercury retrograde. However, we're moving into this Aries new moon, or Aries full moon, as I should call it, which is a fire sign. So it's going to bring a lot of fiery energy. Fiery energy can bring a lot of calmness, or fire energy can bring up a lot of anger issues. It can be destructive. It can burn things down. However, fire energy is a sign of rebirth. Fire energy is burning down the old to bring in the new. From ashes to ashes, dust to dust, okay? As I call it, okay? So it's really that time to get focused on your projects. Review from the past 6 months, especially like whatever projects you guys were looking at. Now is the time when you guys would be like, you know, I'm now starting to get back into that project that, you know, I once upon started a while ago, or even just recently also too. What do I want to refix? What do I want to revamp? What is not working? So the creative energy is going to be open a lot more. So pay attention with that. Okay. Just don't force anything, right? Like, doesn't matter what it is, relationships, work, situations, don't force it. Go with the flow. Follow your passions, you guys, okay? Because we all have our own gifts to share. We're all unique. We all have something to bring to the world or even within ourselves, Okay, make sure you're following that what resonates within yourself. So there's a lot of toxicity that has been shown, and that's just going to continue on for quite some time. Like, you guys are probably noticing that, you know what, like, you know, certain friendships have ended. I just don't get them anymore. They don't get me. We're just walking on two separate paths. Certain relationships that you guys are in, friendships, family, personal relationships, business relationships, you guys have probably found that, you know what? I've been doing a lot of dark night of the soul, and I'm feeling more lonely. I'm just not connecting with them anymore, or them, or that situation. So what's really, really important is for you guys to really take a look within. Okay, be honest with yourself. What have you learned? What are you learning from those situations? Is it time to end that toxic situation within yourself even, right? Well, like, what addictions are you guys struggling with? What are you not happy within yourself? The way you're talking, the way your energy is going out there, is it a weight issue, alcohol, like whatever it is, right? Now is the time. It'll probably still linger on for the rest of this month in October, to be honest with you, but just really pay attention to what is being shown to you. And you know, there's people that are hanging on to certain relationships and they're thinking, you know what, that person is going to change, blah, 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 blah. Okay. However, it comes up to that other person to make that decision if they're ready to make certain changes within themselves. Okay. It's your karma to stay with that energy. If it's toxic or not, then you pay the karmic price and you can't cry about it because you've decided to stick it out. Okay. And that's okay. That is up to you. Nobody has the God-given right to judge anything or anyone. Okay. It's that person's journey. Okay. Some of you have noticed that you've walked away from different jobs, or, you know, as you can see with the world, you know, there's been certain jobs that have ended because you're not vaccinated, right? It is what it is. Maybe it's time that you ended that job, regardless of what. Okay. It gives you that opportunity to take a look at, is that what I really want? Do I really want to be connected with that work environment or not? And if you do, just kind of hang it out, maybe do something else in the meantime. There's so many changes that are constantly, constantly happening, as you guys can see. A lot of different government political issues and stuff like that are being exposed for the ugly truth, as I call it. They're so messed up, but then again, what's new, right? So there's going to be a lot of changes continuing to happening. So just kind of hang in there. The truth always comes out. Pay attention. Okay. Just, you know, really pay attention to what and how is restricting your life. You know, there's certain things that we can change. The only thing you guys have any control over is yourself. So keep that in mind. Okay. I know a lot of you, of course, are being tired of being restricted, being, you know, like with a lot of different limitations. Really take a look at within. Okay. Are you finding yourself stuck or restricted in certain situations yourself, relationships, jobs, environments? Ask yourself, can I change it? Am I not happy where I'm living? Am I not happy with my job relationship? Take that time to do that reflection within to make those changes. Okay. So many things are coming to the surface that needs to be healed. Okay. Your inner child has been screaming to you guys, you know, like, help, we need help here. We need, you know, we're wounded. A lot of these traumas are coming to the surface. A lot of these emotions are coming to surface. And take that time to be grateful for that. Don't run. Don't run from that, because that's a gift from your soul to show you what you guys need to change, what you guys need to resolve yet. Okay. So there's a lot of energy that are going to be coming up until next year, 2022 in October. Okay. This virus, COVID and all of that, from what I read into and I see myself personally, 2024, things are going to start to come more so to a conclusion with that. So things are going to start to get a lot better after that. But until then, just go with the flow. Okay, certain timelines also, you guys, 1994 to 1999, 2005 to 2008, similar circumstances are coming forth right now that you guys, if you can remember back then, what you were you doing? Like what was going on back then? You've noticed that certain things have coming to the surface again. Okay, just really pay attention to what you guys learned back then. And you can always make that change then when you can see certain similarities coming forth right now. You know, even some trends are coming back actually from the past. You know, like the olden days, you know, certain fashions, certain styles, certain trends, things like that. And it's, you're going to find that it's going to kind of complement where we are now, right? So for some of you, let's say that like the 60s or the 80s looked or certain things like that, you're going to find that, you know, I like those fashions or styles or, you know, like how things were done back then. Things are coming back. You're going to see certain styles, like I said, that are going to be coming back. And it's going to be very cool, actually. Right? So just, you know, be your authentic self. Go with your own truth, right? Nobody has the right to say you shouldn't wear your hairstyle like that. You shouldn't, you know, wear your makeup like that. You, like, screw that, right? Be yourself. Be your true, authentic self. That's all that matters. Okay? A lot of you are wanting to spend more time alone. Okay, which is a blessing because the more time you spend alone, the more you're going to hear your soul speak, right? Quiet meditation time. For those guys, for those of you who actually know me, you know that I spent a lot of years being alone, meditating, doing all that dark night of the soul. A lot of you call me the Tibetan monk, right? I do a lot of meditating, you know, like we all have stuff that we have to process and go through and clear. Okay, so I've done a lot of work within. And we all have work to do within, right? Like even to the day we die, we're still going to be learning lessons and processing things and doing our evolution and all of that. We all have that journey. Even to the day we die. And even the day we die, we have then a new journey into the spirit world, as I call it, of a new life, learning lots of different things, right? So just make sure that you guys, you know, like pay attention. What's ending right now? You know, are you guys happy, truly, truly happy with your relationships? Are you truly happy with your job? Are you truly happy with like, where you're living, like everything, review everything. Okay. Like your soul is trying to align you within, and it brings up a lot of stuff that needs clearing. There's a lot of past karmic situations, relationships that need to be ended, that need to be cleared. For some of you, it's important that it's like, you know what? I'm not ready to leave. Then don't. Right? Sometimes we have to go through certain situations and relationships, whatever it is, and finally we're like, you know what? That's it. I'm done. I've learned my lesson. I know my self-worth. I know what I want. Set boundaries. Set boundaries. You see the phone ringing and you're like, oh God, I don't want to talk to them. Why? Like, why answer the phone, right? Get back to them at your own time. If your job texts you, hey, can you come in? If you don't want to go in, don't. Set boundaries. Okay? You know, like go in your own comfort zone, right? Like I'm not telling you guys to quit your job or end a relationship. That's up to you. That is up to you. Okay? We all have our own journey. Don't judge ever, ever, ever. Okay? Utilize this energy to the fullest. Okay, this full moon energy can be very, you know, like violent, as I call it. A lot of dark forces are going to come to the surface with a lot of things that are going to be exposed, the ugliness again, right? That's just going to continue on. So it matters to how are you handling it? Are you guys grounded? You know, or as long as you're centered within, that's all that matters, right? Like I work with people, as you guys know, I'm clairvoyant. I do past life Akashic records, you know, soulmate, twin flame readings. I'm an animal communicator. I, you know, talk to people who have passed on and animals, lots of different things. So we all have our own path. Go with what you resonate with. So, you know, we're in that ascension time, you know, a huge ascension time. And, you know, different times we get different physical Energy coming forth from our body. Okay. It's like just recently, even now, some of you are experiencing like nausea, headaches, really, really tiredness. Okay. Drink more water. Okay. Like your body needs rest. Some of you guys might be finding you're a little bit more gassy, you're bloated, a lot of body aches coming, a lot of pressure too, in your forehead, third eye gland, shoulder aches, knee aches, right knee aches, heart palpitations. You guys might find that some of you guys are like craving like sweets, like chocolate, like crazy, right? And some of you are like, you know what? I can't eat anything. I just, you know, like I just maybe want to like have smoothies or go on a fast, or I can only just eat like vegetables or whatever it is. Some people are like, I can't eat meat anymore. You know, where some people are like, God, all I'm craving is protein, like meat or whatever. Go on your own vibe, right? When we're born, you know, like in the Jyotish Vedic astrology, you know, we know that what hair color we're going to have, what eye color we're going to have, what skin color, what culture we're going to be in. We're going to know if we're going to be a vegan, or a meat eater, whatever. All of that is pre-programmed. That's why certain people, they try to force themselves to do certain changes, and you keep on finding that it keeps on going back. We can follow a certain diet and routine for a certain long, but then all of a sudden we get that craving for meat or whatever. That's why. Okay. So that's why we're all different. Just make sure that you guys really pay attention to what your soul is showing you. I can't explain that enough. I can't express that enough. Stay in gratitude with what lessons, review the lessons you guys have learned. Okay. And be grateful. Be truly grateful. There's people out there that are living on the street. They have nowhere to go. No family, no nothing. Okay, so be grateful and thankful for what has ended. You guys have to remember that spirit steps in to protect you and closes doors on relationships, on jobs, on situations. Like I was trying to move for a little while yet to, Vancouver Island. But yet I kept on feeling, you know what? I don't belong there. It's not the right time, you know? So there's reasons for that. Maybe I'm not supposed to be there. Maybe it's just not the right timing. Maybe I'm going to be moving somewhere else, whatever. You have to surrender and trust the process. Absolutely everything. Because when you guys hold on to something so tightly, it falls apart. And emotions are just energy. When you get your emotions stuck, it causes so many blockages within your chakras that it's going to block prosperity. It's going to block success. It's going to block new opportunities coming to you. So you need to feel the pain. Feel the pain of what spirit and your soul is bringing forth. It's that opportunity to release, resolve, surrender. We're still in Mercury retrograde vibes for a couple of more weeks. Utilize this energy to the fullest. To the fullest. Okay? Treat each other with a lot of love and respect. We're all teachers. If you pay attention, we all are teaching each other lessons. If you pay attention from soul, not ego. Right. I had somebody ask me a question the other day saying, okay, Jenny, what does this mean? So I gave them the definition and they said, well, I already knew that. And then I thought, you know, why would you put your guards up to me and say you already know that when you clearly asked me, what does it mean? Think of that. Is that not ego? Okay. So they have issues they have to deal with themselves, like we all do, of course. Right. But just think of that, okay? You know, reach out for help if you need it. That's why I'm saying we're all teachers. You know, I had another friend actually say something like, oh, this is what's going to be happening to me and stuff like that, you know, which I was truly, truly happy for her to be evolving, moving forward, you know, and I just made a comment of, you know, just be careful of this thing here because... And I gave her all of the reasons because it can be very dangerous if you're not doing it properly. And I'm not going to go into details. It can cause a lot of chaotic energy if you're not in awareness. And I really see that she was not ready for it. And I spoke to her out of my heart and immediately attack went up. guards went up and she says, oh, I've known this for 20 some years. I know what I'm doing. I've been through this, all of that ego. The guards went up automatically. And I stepped back and I just said, okay, I wish you the best. You know, I truly, really hope that, you know, she really gets the help that she truly needs. I love her dearly. She's a good friend. But sometimes we have to let certain people go so they can walk their own path, of course. And, you know, if somebody really wants help, they'll ask for it. Okay. And, you know, you guys can always book a session with me, soulworkwithjenny.com. I'll put that information in the description box from my website. And, you know, when I read someone, I read your soul, I read what lessons, what things are coming to the surface for you. I read your level of consciousness to see where you're at and expand it from there on. Okay, so just remember not to chase anything. Let things come to you. Like, go after your goals and your passion. Keep moving forward, you know, and allow things to come to you. And remember, you attract who you are, not what you want. Okay, so if you guys start attracting certain situations and things to you, ask yourself, how did I attract that, right? Sometimes things come to us because it gives us that opportunity to clear past karmic situations, you know, with people and situations and stuff like that. And then it's like, I'm so grateful that I worked through that and let it go. You know, much gratitude, always, always, always. Okay, so anyways, let's just pull a couple of cards from Spirit, as I say. And any card deck you guys use, I never use cards in my readings because I'm clairvoyant, by the way. But knock them 3 times on wood because that clears out the energy from the last person who used the deck to yourself or whatever. Okay, so we're just going to be doing this basically on a collective from what Spirit has to say, you know, for the rest of the month here in October, how we can work through Mercury retrogrades, you know, aftermath, the full moon, and yourselves. All right, Spirit, what is my message, or what is your message, I should say, for the universal energy for everybody right now? What is your message from Spirit? I'm not picking that up. I didn't feel it. It just fell out. What's your message? Oh, wow. Now that's a card that flies out, and that's what I utilize. Okay, so right here it says, find the blessings in your current situation. Absolutely. So everything that you guys go through, you know, find the blessing in it, right? You know how I keep talking about be grateful, be in gratitude. You know, as long as you're learning from lessons and situations and such like that, that's all that matters, right? You know, doors closed. That's a blessing in disguise, right? Spirit has a tendency to step in and close certain doors for you, right? You know, like sometimes you're, you know, like your system goes down, internet goes down, you can't work, right? We all get frustrated, but maybe that's also a time for you to take that quiet time alone. Maybe you guys have been working too hard and you're like, God, I'm so burnt out, right? I need rest. Hello. Always see the positive in things, right? Always send love out to the universe and everyone. Okay, so what's another message from Spirit? Okay, so that's too many. What's another message from Spirit? What is another message? When I'm feeling the energy, that's when I gravitate towards this. What's a message collectively for the universe to guide us with? What is a collective universal message right now? What is a collective universal message? There we go. Absolutely. Clear your shield and energy. Okay. Remember how I said, whenever you guys hang on to your emotions and you don't work through it, it creates blocks in your chakras. Okay. When it creates blocks in your chakras, you're not seeing things clearly. You're blocking anything that's coming to you. So as I always say to Spirit, you know, if I'm looking for new opportunities with, you know, whatever it is, right? Relationships, jobs, work, like whatever, right? I always say, Spirit, I'm open to what is best for my highest self and highest purpose. I am ready. Okay, so make sure you stay in that alignment, stay in higher consciousness, you know, work through it. Just keep on working through it, you guys. Like, don't be hard on yourself, right? Like, you know, there's a lot of things that I'm very sensitive. I tune into absolutely everything and I don't say very much. I keep a lot to myself. I'm an observer and, you know, I'm just like, yeah, absolutely. Okay, because when I read into somebody's level of consciousness, I want to be onto their zone so they will understand what I'm saying in order to help that person. However, if you or anybody has your guards up and you're living in ego, it's not going to make a difference what I say or anybody says to you. Okay, so you have to be truly open and ready to embrace the beautiful messages from the spirit world when and if you're ready. Okay, so again, for those of you who would like to book an appointment with me, I read into your level of consciousness to see where you're at and expand it in ways to help you get clarity in all areas of your life, plus my insights. Book through my website, soulworkwithjenny.com. So remember to subscribe to my YouTube channel, click the like button, make some comments. All right, everyone, sending you much love and light, Jenny.